There are now calls for a people's initiative to reverse the House panel ruling denying ABS-CBN a fresh franchise. To talk more about this, joining us is USD law professor, attorney Enrique de la Cruz. Attorney, good afternoon and thanks so much for joining us.
Good afternoon for having me. Thank you.
First of all, what's your assessment of the vote on the franchise that happened yesterday?
Well, as we can see, it was drawn on political lines. Most of the allies of the president voted to deny the franchise. And the authors, primarily from the Liberal Party, voted to grant it. Surprise are some of the members of the opposition, especially the minority floor leader, Bishop Benny Abante, voted in favor of ABS-CBN.
Mm-hmm. Well, tell us about this option for a people's initiative. What law or precedent would make it possible?
Yes, you know, the Constitution allows for the people to directly propose laws which Congress is unwilling to pass as a law. In 1989, Congress itself passed a law, RA-6735, to implement the provision of the Constitution on people's initiative. Under this law, all we need is a proposition, a proposal coming from any citizen, basically, or any group. It will be submitted to the COMELEC, provided it has the required number of signatures. For a national law, you need 10% of the total number of registered voters in the country, whereby each legislative district should be represented by at least 3% in that signature gathering. And once you have the required signatures, the COMELEC will review the petition, and within 30 days from their review of the form and substance of the petition, they will publish the petition in a newspaper of general circulation twice. After that, they will schedule the referendum, not later than 45 days, not earlier than 45 days, not later than 90 days. And then you have it. The whole country will vote on whether they are willing to grant a renewal of the franchise of ABS-CBN. And that becomes law.
It will become law, and the Congress and even the president cannot reverse it. What about the COMELEC? Is it something that the COMELEC would be able to budget for or even support logistically?
That's an interesting question, Rain. In 2017, there was a citizen named Engineer Marmeto who filed a petition in the COMELEC because he wanted a local ordinance to be enacted by the Sangguniang Panglungsod of Muntinlupa. But the Sangguniang said that they don't have the budget for that initiative. They refused it. So he went to the COMELEC and asked that the COMELEC conduct the initiative. The COMELEC denied Mr. Marmeto his right for an initiative, arguing that they don't have a budget for it. The case reached the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court said that the COMELEC cannot refuse an invocation of people's initiative on the ground of lack of budget. They have to use whatever budget they have for purposes of implementing the law on people's initiative. So to answer your question, the COMELEC cannot refuse on the ground of lack of budget.
Mm-hmm. You're telling us about the mechanics for a people's initiative. You also have a very popular president. Won't a vote for ABS-CBN, a people's initiative for ABS-CBN, be seen as a referendum against this government?
Well, I never said it would be easy. Admittedly, it will be difficult since the president is a very popular president. He has many supporters. If he campaigns against the initiative, it might make people hesitate. But if we are to believe the presidential spokesperson, Harry Roque, saying that the president is neutral on the issue, then we might have in our hands the first time that the people's initiative will be successful. I think that even if the president campaigns against ABS-CBN or any other oppositor, I think the Filipino people will be mature enough to consider the matter and vote objectively.
Mm-hmm. Now, aside from the People's Initiative, what other legal remedies might be available to both ABS and its 11,000 employees?
You can ask another member of the House to refile the bill, but since a refiling of the bill will be submitting the same proposal to the same people who rejected it, it would be a long shot. Or another alternative is to wait until the next Congress, meaning until after the term of the president, where the people will be electing a new president and a new Congress, and then refile the petition or bill in Congress.
Mm-hmm. Another question, Attorney, can ABS-CBN sue President Duterte once his term ends in 2022 and the congressman who voted against the franchise renewal? And if yes, what case can ABS-CBN file against them?
It would be hard to assess if there is any liability without identifying specific charges. I can only state what the law says. The president is immune from suit during and even after his term for acts done in relation to his office. So yes, he may be sued after his term if he has committed any crimes, for example, because the law and the Constitution does not protect a sitting president from criminal liability. He cannot be sued during his term, but he may be sued after if it is a crime. For civil action for damages, for example, I doubt if that will fly or will be given due course. As I said, the rule is that the president or members of Congress, for that matter, people acting in their official capacities, cannot be held liable for acts done in relation to their office unless they commit a crime.
What about a crime on freedom of against freedom of speech and freedom of the press? What kind of legal remedies might be available toward addressing that?
There are criminal statutes punishing public officials for violating the rights of its citizens, and it is the person complaining who has the burden of proof. And yes, it can be filed after the term of the official, not just the president, but also the members of Congress. But as I said, the quantum of proof is too high, a bar, and you need to convince a prosecutor that there is probable cause. So unless the evidence is very glaring, I think it would be hard to prove a criminal case arising from violation of rights unless you have an actual testimony or affidavit saying that the president directly ordered that the franchise of ABS-CBN be denied for political purposes.
Well, still a battle, an uphill climb for ABS-CBN and the press. Thank you so much for weighing in on the issue, Attorney Enrique de la Cruz, professor for the University of Santo Tomas. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.